Good evening. I'm John Stevenson, Chairman of the Board of Directors of AmeriCU Credit Union. On behalf of the board, the supervisory committee, and the staff, I would like to welcome you to our 71st annual membership meeting. At this time, I'd like to take a moment to welcome AmeriCU's president and CEO, Ron Belle. Ron was selected as the credit union CEO in May of 2020, but has been part of AmeriCU's chief leadership team since 2017, previously holding the position of chief experience officer. Ron continues to focus on making AmeriCU a better place to work, a better place to bank, and a stronger credit union overall. We are thrilled to have him at the helm and are looking forward to working with him for many years to come. At this time, I'd like to invite Ron to say a few words. Ron?
Thank you, John, and good afternoon, everyone. It is an honor to be part of this organization since 2017, and as CEO, it's a privilege to work with a team of professionals who are committed to living AmeriCU's vision, mission, and MVP One Team culture. This year, we all have experienced changes to the ways we work and live our lives. I'm extraordinarily proud of how the team has overcome every business challenge with the resilience necessary to grow our organization as we all expand our products and services for our members. None of that could have been possible without the daily commitment of the AmeriCU team. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank every member of the AmeriCU team for their continued support and commitment to our mission. I would equally like to thank the members of AmeriCU's Board of Directors for their support, hard work, and dedication throughout the year. The Board of Directors are volunteers who give their time to serve the credit union and our membership. Without their support, AmeriCU Credit Union and the AmeriCU team could not be successful. Each year, the annual meeting is an event that we look forward to sharing with our members. Thank you all for joining us this evening. Like so many things during this year, we have had to change and adapt. Take this meeting, for example. This is the first time we have live streamed our annual meeting. Throughout tonight's meeting, please submit your comments and questions to annualmeeting@americu.org. We will be sure to address all comments and questions within 48 hours. For your convenience, this meeting is being recorded. The recording and accompanying meeting materials will be available online at americu.org/annualmeeting. We hope you enjoy this evening's virtual presentation. I will now turn it back over to John Stevenson to officially call the meeting to order.
Thank you, Ron. We have declare that a quorum is present. I'd like to call the 71st annual membership meeting to order. The AmeriCU Board of Members present are myself, John Stevenson, Chairman of the Board, George C. Bauer III, Vice Chairman of the Board, Ryan Coons, Recording Officer, Terry Telewicki, Chief Financial Officer, Joseph J. Terzin, Director, Jennifer Stoll, Director, Nicola Fabrizio, Director, and from the Supervisory Committee, Glenn Gaskin, Chairman, Robert J. Angelhow, Member, and Lester Burke, Member. I'll ask for a motion for approval of the agenda as published and made available to all members present. Do I have a motion? Do I have a second? Please vote now. The agenda is approved. May I have a motion for approval of the 70th annual meeting minutes as printed? May I have a second for that motion? Please vote now. The minutes are approved. A copy of the 2020 annual report has been made available to all members in attendance tonight. May I have a motion for approval of the reports as published in the 2020 annual report? May I have a second for this motion? Please vote now. The annual report documents are approved as presented. At this time, I will provide a report for the nominating committee. The nominating committee is comprised of Ms. Darlene Burns, Mr. Thomas Harding, and myself. The committee, after reviewing all applications received, nominated two candidates for the seats. Therefore, no mail ballot was needed this year as required by AmeriCU bylaws. By operation of the bylaws and there being no other candidates, the two people were seated as follows: Joseph Terson, incumbent to a 3-year term; George Bauer, incumbent to a 3-year term. 2020 has been a year unlike any other. We face unprecedented challenges on a global scale as well as right here in our own community. The pandemic has had a dramatic effect on all our lives and has touched very close to home for many of us. However, through these difficult times, we have realized our resilience and strengths as a community. Please join me in taking a moment to recognize our essential workers, our first responders, and healthcare professionals for their heroic efforts during the pandemic. Pictured here are some of the brave men and women of AmeriCU who volunteer their time as first responders. We also honor those who have lost their lives or lives of a loved one during this most difficult time. This year, the heart of the credit union movement, People Helping People, has taken on an even greater meaning. Our goal throughout the pandemic has been to continue to provide exceptional service to our members while ensuring their safety and the safety of our employees. In February and March of 2020, as we saw the virus gaining momentum, we quickly developed and executed plans to ensure the safety of our members and staff. We limited lobby access at financial centers, minimized in-person meetings, and launched an online appointment scheduling system. We developed procedures to allow many of our support staff to work from home and put in place additional safety measures to protect our member-facing staff, including supplying masks and hand sanitizers for all our employees, adding protective barriers to our teller lines, increasing sanitation measures, and limiting financial center capacity when necessary. At AmeriCU, we quickly realized that for some, the pandemic would lead to financial uncertainty, and we were prepared to help our members in any way possible. We assisted our business members in applying for and securing PPP loans, provided members with mortgage and home equity relief, and skip a payment options. We also encouraged the use of transaction methods that require minimal to no contact, including online and mobile banking, self-serve kiosks, ATMs, drive-through services, our member service center, and online appointment scheduling. We are extremely proud of the commitment of our AmeriCU team of employees working alongside our members as a trusted financial partner and supporting them throughout this year. The dedication of our team has been nothing short of exemplary, as evidenced by our achievement of a member satisfaction score of 9.77 out of 10. Our employees have responded admirably to the challenges of the pandemic, not only by serving our members, but our community as well. They donated face masks to several local hospitals, delivered food to local healthcare workers, and collected and donated food for the Salvation Army. Charity and philanthropy will continue to play a vital role in our organization beyond the pandemic as we strive to not only be the credit union of choice, but also the organization of choice, admired for our impact in the community and the standards by which we live. At this time, I'll turn it back over to our President and CEO, Ron Belle, to continue our 2020 year in review. Ron?
Thank you again, John. With much of our year focused on the pandemic, we still made time to celebrate as we marked our 70th anniversary on October 15th. We reflected on our rich history of AmeriCU Credit Union and marked this important milestone for our organization. We engaged our members, community, and employees in the celebration as we turned back the time to the 1950s. The celebration included 1950s themed decorations in all financial centers and department offices, member giveaways, employee 50s themed costume contest, a new 1950s themed television commercial, and a week of social media contests with 1950s themed prizes. With our members at the center of all decisions, we continue to revise and improve our product and service offerings, finding new ways to meet members' needs. For example, today, members can schedule convenient meeting times in any one of our financial centers to meet with a financial professional. From the convenience of your home or office with the use of your smartphone or home computer, you choose the time that works best for your schedule to meet with us. This year, we introduced AmeriCU PaySaver Auto Loans, which provides members an auto loan payment similar to what you might expect to pay for a lease payment, but our members maintain ownership of the vehicle, providing our members the flexibility to trade in or sell that vehicle when it's most convenient for them. We also added three new loan products for our homeowners: the AmeriCU Home Improvement Loan, AmeriCU Home Renovation Loan, and a new line of AmeriCU Dream Mortgage products that earned AmeriCU a ranking as one of the top mortgage lenders in the Utica and Syracuse markets in 2020. And for our members who own businesses, we enhanced our cash management capabilities and introduced electronic payment and secure transmission options for your safety and soundness when you're conducting your businesses. Despite the global and local economic challenges of 2020, AmeriCU continued to grow. We exceeded industry growth averages in two key performance areas, total assets and total membership. Overall asset growth was just under 22% for AmeriCU versus an industry growth average of 18%. Total assets grew $399 million last year, moving us past the $2 billion industry milestone to close out the year at over $2.2 billion of total assets. New membership grew 5.02% versus industry average of 3.85%. AmeriCU added close to 7,000 new members, finishing the year slightly under 144,000 total members. As we look forward and toward the coming new year with great enthusiasm at the opportunities that await us to deepen our commitment to our members and further enhance their overall member experience, we continue to add to our chief leadership team. This past September, we welcomed a new Chief Experience Officer, Alyssa Sykes-Tulick. Alyssa will help guide the credit union in executing member and employee-focused initiatives that will continue to build on the success we saw in 2020. In the fourth quarter last year, myself and senior leaders began to develop a new three-year strategic plan for the credit union. Through the planning process, we identified five strategic initiatives that establish a new foundation and focus to continue to grow and meet the needs of our membership. Through the strategic planning process, we also redefined both our organization's vision and mission statements to better align to our new strategic plan. Our vision is to be the most admired organization in every community we serve. That goes beyond being the best financial institution. It involves playing an integral role in our communities and providing our time, our talent, our expertise towards improving the future direction of our local communities, neighborhoods, and civic organizations. It means giving back to our communities through charitable contributions that support local events and local organizations. Being the most admired to me also means maintaining an organization's culture, a culture that focuses on our employees, their increased satisfaction, and their continuous development and skill building and training. It also means an organization that maintains a positive image, exemplifies trust, integrity, member service, and dependability. Our mission is to provide our members with the right financial services to live life, dream big, and achieve financial success. That defines the work we do each day at AmeriCU through every member interaction. Whether a member chooses to go into one of our financial centers, work with us online, or through their mobile device, or through our call center, our mission is the same: to understand your financial needs and provide you with the right solutions to live your life the way you so choose. Finally, AmeriCU looks forward to the coming year with excitement and focus to face the challenges as well as capture the opportunities that 2021 will offer. We are grateful to all of our members who continued this journey with us as your trusted financial partner. Thank you for another successful year, and thank you for choosing AmeriCU. Now we've come to the part of tonight's presentation that we look forward to each and every year. It's the presentation of our scholarship winners. AmeriCU is proud to continue serving our members by awarding scholarships to 10 very deserving young men and women. Their personal and academic accomplishments, community focus, and personal drive to reach their goals is always impressive. To present these awards, I'd like to introduce Joe Turgeon, AmeriCU board member and chairman of the 2021 AmeriCU Scholarship Selection Committee. Joe?
Thank you, Ron. It is my pleasure to serve as the chair of the Scholarship Committee and really enjoyed that role tremendously. We are proud to continue this tradition that began over 20 years ago. AmeriCU's scholarship program recognizes the academic excellence of our student members and the importance of investing in their future and the future of the communities we serve. Today, we celebrate the outstanding accomplishments and achievements of these students. AmeriCU is honored to support and encourage you as you dream big and pursue your goals. I am pleased to announce that for 2021, our scholarship committee received and reviewed 106 applications, 54 of which were from high school students and 52 from college students, both graduate and undergraduate. This evening, 10 $1,000 scholarships will be awarded, so please join me in recognizing our 2021 AmeriCU scholarship winners. With that, I'd like to say that in working with the committee, it is amazing. Every year it becomes more and more difficult to determine the top 10 scholarship winners. All of the academians are superb. It is just a daunting task. And we look at five criteria. There's their academics, their scholastic, or their athletic abilities, their community service, any jobs they had, and most important, their essay to do that. So without further ado, our first scholarship winner, and we're going to do the first five high schools first. So our first winner is receiving the Frank Marasco Memorial Scholarship. Frank was a former long-term member of the Board of Directors. He served the credit union during our early years when we were first formed as Griffiths Employees Credit Union, way back in the 50s and 60s. Mr. Marasco served on the Board of Directors from 1962 to 1975 and was Chairman of the Board from 1970 to 71. Okay, starting with our high school scholarships. All right, our first one, and they are in alphabetical order, is Dolan Price. Dolan is a senior at Onondaga High School, where he currently holds a 99.2 average, ranking second in his class. He is a member of several clubs as well, the varsity wrestling, cross country, the track teams, and most notably has interned for Congressman Keiko's re-election campaign in New York's 24th district in Syracuse. In his spare time, Andrew enjoys hiking, politics, and following the stock market and the economy. Julian has applied to several universities for the fall semester where he plans to study business. After college, he hopes to work in the finance industry with a focus on consulting, investment banking, and private equity. Dolan, your check will be forthcoming. Okay, next we have Seth Bailey. Seth is a senior at Fayetteville Manlius High School, where he holds a 99.4 average. He plays on his school basketball and golf teams, is a board member of the Science Honor Society, and is also a member of several clubs. In his spare time, Seth enjoys playing baseball, golfing, and fishing. Seth has applied to several colleges for the fall semester and plans to major in chemistry. After college, he plans to attend dental school and become an orthodontist and hopes to one day make orthodontics care more accessible to underprivileged communities. Congratulations, Seth, and again, your check will be forthcoming. Next is Andrew Fox. Andrew is a senior at Little Falls High School, where he currently holds a 98.8 average, ranking third in his class. Andrew holds the esteemed position of president of the New York State chapter of the Future Business Leaders of America. He also served as the class vice president, is a member of several clubs, and played for his school's volleyball team. In his spare time, Andrew enjoys hiking, traveling, and experiencing new cultures. Andrew has developed a passion for business and hospitality management after interning at Hotel Utica this past year. He has applied to several universities for the fall semester and hopes to major in business management or hotel administration. And Andrew, if you stick with business management, remember AmeriCU. We'll be very interested in you in the next 4 years. Next, and again, your check will be forthcoming. Next is Rihanna Huko. Rihanna is a senior at Herkimer High School, where she is first in her class with a 4.0 grade point average. She is currently the vice president of the National Honor Society, is a member of the varsity tennis team, and is very active in her church community. In her spare time, Rihanna enjoys digital design, reading, and painting. Rihanna has applied also to several colleges for the fall semester, hopes to major in computer science, and one day wants to work in a lead position as a computer programmer or software engineer. Rihanna, I want you to, when you get done with 4 years, to make sure you look up, there's the Air Force Research Laboratory here in Rome, and that's what we hire, tremendous amount of CompSci people, and we're looking for computer programmers all the time. So remember, after 4 years, we'll be interested in you. Next is, excuse me, Okay, that concludes the five high school students that will be entering college this fall. Now we go to the five college students that are either in college, progressing through college, going for master's or beyond. Our first award winner is Jacqueline Gamlin. Jacqueline is currently enrolled in Cazenovia College, where she majors in English and Communication Studies, minors in social media production, and has a 3.8 grade point average. She is a classically trained pianist, plays the oboe, and is self-proclaimed environmental enthusiast who enjoys working for and supporting local organizations who work to protect the environment. After college, Jacqueline hopes to pursue a career in public relations to support local and nonprofit organizations which directly align with her personal mission to champion and advocate for grassroots efforts through strong and effective public relations, marketing, and communications. Jacqueline, again, your check will be forthcoming.
Real quickly, just forgot Lauren. Hmm. Lauren, previous page.
I have Jaden.
One more high school.
One more high school.
Oh, okay, right. Thanks.
Thank you.
Sorry, need to go back. We had one more high school individual that I skipped over. My apology. Lauren Jedruzic. Lauren is a busy senior completing not only her high school courses, but college courses from the University of Valley Forge as part of a dual enrollment program. She is also very active in her church community, volunteering in the children's and special needs ministry programs and community outreach events. In her spare time, she enjoys hiking, singing, is a self-taught guitarist, and is currently learning to play the piano and ukulele. Lauren plans to study psychology this fall in college and hopes one day to pursue her master's and PhD. Okay, so that concluded the five scholarships for high school, and I indicated the one for college. We'll move on to the second college award winner, Jaden Hand. Jaden is in her second semester at Colgate University, where she is majoring in molecular biology and Spanish and holds a 3.59 GPA. She is actively involved on campus, is a member of several clubs, and is particularly interested in the arts, primarily drawing, painting, as well as jewelry making and other crafts. After college, Jaden plans to pursue a career in research, where she will study the field of genetics, hoping one day to make a positive contribution in the advancement of medicine, gene therapy, or yet to be discovered various techniques. Jaden, your check will be again forthcoming, and congratulations. Next, we have Sydney Havens. Sydney is a sophomore studying broadcast and mass communication with a minor in French cultural studies at Oswego State. She currently holds a 4.0 GPA, is a teacher's assistant, a member of several clubs and honor societies, and is very active in her community. In her spare time, Sydney enjoys bowling, hiking, painting, and helping with her grandmother's business. Journalism has been Sydney's passion since she was 12 years old, and once finished at Oswego, she wants to pursue her master's degree in broadcast journalism at NYU and hopes to one day be an international reporter. So congratulations on your award, and again, it'll be forthcoming. Next, we have Ashley Hodge. Ashley is a graduate student at Texas A&M University in Kingsville, Texas, where she is currently working on her master's degree in range and wildlife management. In her program, Ashley studies the movements of large animals like deer and cattle to better understand their role in the expansion of Lyme disease. In her spare time, Ashley enjoys hiking, backpacking, and writing. After she receives her master's, Ashley hopes to pursue her PhD and one day have a career in wildlife management and public health, working to educate communities on the effects of tick-borne diseases. Ashley had a very unique essay, and again, congratulations, your check will be forthcoming. And last, we have David Teska. David is a sophomore mechanical engineering student at Clarkson University and was a recipient of the 2020 scholarship, so we are elated that he could accept this award once again this year. As a student, David is currently working in the TARS lab, which stands for Terrascale All Sensing Research Studio, where he works on several robotics and megatonics projects. He can directly apply what he is learning in the classroom to real-time research and projects. After college, David hopes to establish relationships through internships and research and one day work for an engineering firm working to improve the lives of others, one technological innovation at a time. Okay. Those were our five college award winners. Again, superb young individuals that met all the five criteria, did superb, and of course had excellent essays. Congratulations to our scholarship winners. I would also like to recognize the contribution of this year's scholarship selection committee. The individuals who dedicated many hours and careful thoughts to the selection of our winners, going over all these over 100 applications. Please join me in acknowledging those committee members that I couldn't do it without: Donna Wagner, Lou Marina, and Jim Cusack. I will now welcome back John Stevenson to close out this year's meeting. John?
Thank you, Joe, and thank you to your committee. Congratulations again to our scholarship winners. Due to the virtual nature of this year's annual meeting, door prize winners will be selected and contacted after the meeting. All members who have logged into the meeting will be automatically entered into the door prize drawing. On behalf of the AmeriCU Board of Directors, thank you for attending this evening's meeting. We appreciate your adaptability to a virtual event. If you have any questions, please email them to annualmeeting@AmeriCU.org, and we will address your concerns individually. As a reminder, a recording of today's meeting and corresponding material can be found at AmeriCU.org/annualmeeting. Thank you once again. I wish everyone a happy and healthy new year. Be safe. Thank you.